今年4月19日是谷雨节气，联合国中文日意为谷雨这一天，以纪念仓颉造字的贡献。中新社近日推出汉学家画汉字策划，邀请部分汉学家或汉学青年讲述他们与汉字的缘分。
Hello everybody, I'm Michael Lahanzi. Coming up is a very important day. It's April 19th, and it's important for two reasons. Number one, it is the United Nations Chinese Language Day, or in Chinese, we say 联合国中文日. In traditional Chinese, we separate the year into 24 equal parts, and on April 19th, also, it's called Grain Rain Day.And this time of year, we expect the rain to come down and so that the grain can grow and we'll all have lots of stuff to eat. These two words, grain, rain, in simplified characters are written like this and sometimes misunderstood as valley rain. But actually, the traditional characters come from this and it means grain rain. So the rain comes down and the grain grows and we have lots to eat and everybody learns to speak Chinese.
我们写字的时候，哪怕是临摹啊，我们都会有一种创造的这个空间。就是虽然我们看到啊这个字这个图形包括这个作品的痕迹大概是一个样子。最后要把它体现出来还靠我们自己的这个发挥了。那么这种发挥呢是一个不断的挑战。就在你书写的过程当中呢，你就会觉得虽然模板是已经别人写过的，但是在你这个挥毫的过程当中好比是你自己在写。有这么一种充满着创造力和这种发挥余地的这么一种感觉。所以呢我认为这个写字是一个永恒的创作。
我叫台密霞，这个台密霞是我中文名字。我高中已经开始学了中文，那为什么开始这么早？是因为我14岁的时候就接触到一部中国经典叫道德经，也叫老子，然后对这些哲学感兴趣，所以想这个原文怎么读。我也很幸运，因为当时我高中也有汉语的课，所以我就开始读。所以今年是30年，就是已经学了30年的中文。
In Rwanda, a lot of people learn Chinese, mostly young people, because Chinese now is an international language.And we also have a lot of people who do business here in China and others who are students here. So it has become a popular language in my country. So what is my best and the most liked Chinese character? The best one is Tian because it's part of my name. And I think it means gold, heaven or something related to the sky. And that meaning can also be found in my first name.And I think Chinese characters are a very good way to represent things which are around us.
觉得真的很幸运能够在中国去那么多的讲汉字文化的博物馆，让我从另外一个层面去了解汉字的文化。现在呢，很多地方其实也在用这些寓教于乐的方式去传播中国汉字的文化，所以我觉得已经成功的吸引我们这样的国际友人，希望以后更多的国际友人能够更深入的了解中国的汉字文化，它背后的魅力真的是比你想象的多的很多。
제가당초에한자를공부하기시작했을때는그각골문이나금문방면에그관심이많았습니다그래서그쪽을공부하고있었는데우연한기회에그한자의이체자에대해서관심을갖게되었고그에따라서그이체자를공부하기시작했습니다그래서그결과적으로처음에접한것이한국의고려대장경을접했고그안에있는이체자를전부수집정리해서하나의책으로만들었는데그것이바로고려대장경이체자전입니다그리고그후에그고려대장경이외의문헌에서나오는많은이체자들을수집하고분석하고정리해서 폭넓은 방향에서 이 책자를 바라보고 새로 분석해서 만들어낸 책이 그 한자 이책자 연구라는 책으로서 근래에 출판되었습니다. 그리고 지금은 한국에 한 1200여 년 전에 화엄사에 있는 화엄석경이 있었는데 그 잔편이 지금까지 전해져 오고 있습니다. 그 잔편에 나오는 글자들을 집중적으로 공부하고 있습니다. 그 안에 있는 이책자를 특히 공부하고 있습니다.